Hi, I'm Dr. Joel Kahn. I'm a triple board certified cardiologist. Happy Heart Month. I am at my clinic, the Kahn Center for Cardiac Longevity in suburban Detroit. I want to take a few minutes to talk to you about Heart Month and how to never have a heart attack. Please let me share my screen for a moment and we will proceed. And please share this with your loved ones, relatives, coworkers. How to never have a heart attack. Clinical professor of medicine, Wayne State University School of Medicine, my 31st year of practice. Over 400 years ago, a very bright physician in England, Thomas Sydenham, MD, said, a man is as old as his arteries. We would clearly say today, a person is as old as their arteries, but this was very visionary because it's proven to be true. Young arteries, young body, old arteries, old body. How do you know how old your arteries are? It's so important. And in fact, you know that you're not walking around with the widowmaker lesion in your proximal left anterior descending heart artery where the black arrow is pointing that could threaten your very life with no symptoms warning you that you're developing this. How do you know? Let's talk about that. Well, let's talk about clues to silent heart blockage. Believe it or not, your earlobe can tell you. The diagonal earlobe crease, or DELC, shown here with the red arrow, is about 70% accurate. 70% accurate is as accurate as a routine stress test for predicting clogged heart arteries. However, if you have a diagonal earlobe crease, don't get anxious, just get checked. It's wrong about 30% of the time. How about men with erectile dysfunction? Is that a clue? Absolutely. Science for over 20 years says men with erectile dysfunction have an early warning that heart arteries are clogging, the so-called canary in the coal mine, an early warning system. Please ask your medical team for a complete and thorough checkup if you're starting to have erectile dysfunction. And how good are doctors at predicting clogged heart arteries? We're not very good using stethoscope and routine physical exam. Winston Churchill never would have been predicted to live to 91 with a big fat cigar in his hand and a very obese body morphology. How about Jim Fix in the 1970s, the most famous runner in America who drops dead of advanced heart arteries? Would we in the medical community be able to predict this? Absolutely not. But how are we going to do it to prevent heart attacks? You need to get a CT scan of your heart. It's called a coronary artery calcium score, a CACS CT scan. Good news, no needle, no iodine, no injection, no exercise. It's available in your local hospital. It used to be $1,000. In Cleveland, they give them away for free. In my city, for $75 cash. You do it once with the same radiation exposure as a mammogram, and you know what Dr. Sydenham talked about. Are you aging inside? Person A has no symptoms and has no calcification or aging of their heart arteries. Person C has no symptoms, but has major, major aging of the heart arteries as shown by the yellow arrow. You simply have to get this simple CT scan. What about extra lab tests? Absolutely. We haven't changed the lab panel in 40 years, and we should. Check your lipoprotein little A. I wrote a book about it. You can read it at some point. There's great recipes in the book. But you must know if you're one of the 25% of people, that's 90 million in America and over a billion worldwide, that inherited this potentially dangerous cholesterol particle. It's just a simple lab test. You simply have to ask your medical team, I know you may not have done it before, but please check my lipoprotein A blood level. And adopt habits that take you to 85% prevention of heart attacks. Don't smoke, walk every day. Eat more than 5 servings of fruit and vegetables a day, which is only 5% of Americans at best. Sleep 7 to 8 hours a night, not 4 hours. And don't overdrink, but a few glasses of red wine a week in this study was protective. And finally, should you find heart disease, know that it can be reversed. This is over 30 years ago that Dr. Dean Ornish published this award-winning research and book, and it still works. It was based on an observation in 1940s in World War II that when food got sparse in Norway, the heart disease death rate plummeted because people were eating from their garden and from the forest. And this was studied after World War II by many pioneers, including Nathan Pritikin. He was indeed an engineer, and he used his engineering mind to create a diet of plants and a diet of fitness, and showed you could reverse not only heart disease, but diabetes, blood pressure, obesity, and cholesterol issues without prescription drugs. He published over 100 research papers involving thousands of patients. And there still is a Pritikin Longevity Center in Miami that you should visit one day and maybe stay for a week. All Mr. Pritikin wanted to do was wipe out these chronic diseases that come from lifestyle, including heart attacks. Then the famous Dean Ornish, MD, who used a plant-forward diet, moderate exercise, stress reduction, and smoking cessation, studied seriously advanced heart disease patients and showed in a randomized study that you could actually reverse cholesterol deposits. The black circles show over 5 years, patients with blocked arteries got worse and worse. The arrow and the line is going up. In the white boxes are patients who adopted the plant Ornish diet, the exercise, the stress reduction, and the group support, and their arteries got cleaner and cleaner over time. Radically important and hopeful news. Indeed, it took a while, but in 2010, Medicare and then other insurance companies now approve patients with heart disease to learn the Pritikin Intensive Cardiac Rehab Approach, the Ornish Intensive Cardiac Rehab Approach. It's paid for and it works, and they're very, very careful about what they pay for. You can't talk about heart disease reversal without a quick shout out to the Cleveland Clinic and the pioneer Caldwell Esselstyn, MD, who left his career in breast and thyroid surgery to work on preventive cardiology using plant diets in seriously sick patients in Cleveland. They ate a plant diet, they avoided animal products and oils, and he demonstrated clinically they improved, and when they needed a follow-up angiogram, angiographically, they improved dramatically. Dr. Esselstyn, at age 87, is still leading research and prevention programs at the Cleveland Clinic. In my own clinic in Bingham Farms, Michigan, the Kahn Center, we use carotid ultrasound and we document reversal of plaque using the same approaches that Mr. Pritikin taught, that Dr. Ornish and Dr. Esselstyn taught, and we add in integrative cardiology using science-based supplements to cause reversal of plaque. So look at the yellow line. I was taught in Ann Arbor in medical school, we're born perfect and we just get older, like Dr. Sydenham said 400 years ago. But the yellow line goes both ways. Take away the smoking, take away the sedentary lifestyle, take away the processed and fried foods, add in whole food plant diet, stress reduction, and good sleep, and you can reverse the process. Can you get into trouble eating plant foods? Yes, if they're junk. Stay away from junk food, eat whole food plant meals, and you may need to supplement for optimal vitamin levels, but indeed so should most of the population supplement, at least with vitamin D and perhaps B12. So there are resources. Watch online the movie Forks Over Knives, Cowspiracy, Earthlings, What the Health, the Game Changers movie. Read a great book like The China Study by Dr. Colin Campbell. My book, The Plant-Based Solution, along with other books I've written. Undo It by Dr. Ornish. Reversing Heart Disease by Dr. Joel Furman. They're all great books. Maybe check out pcrm.org, forksoverknives.org, or my own website for multiple recipes and other articles. Finally, the best kept secret in medicine is that under the right conditions, the body can heal itself. And maybe even more important, the best kept secret of medicine is that under the right conditions, the body can never develop diseases we feel are inevitable. So from the Kahn Center for Cardiac Longevity here in Heart Month in Bingham Farms, Michigan, please enjoy, but get tested. Ask for the CT scan, ask for the advanced blood work, including your lipoprotein little a level. Eat your plants, get your sleep, don't smoke, move your body, and get some group support. Thank you.